Bonjour mes amis, I'm Bernadette the Demon Fairy Snail. Welcome back. In this episode of Bernadette Reads Comics, we will be reviewing comics I read the month of September 2018. And remember, when I say pull it, it's good. When I say slime it, it's bad. Okay, let's get started. Doomsday Clock, issue 7 of 12, from DC Comics. Holy slime! This has been an upsetting week when it comes to DC Comics. That hack writer Tom King first ruined Batman and Catwoman's relationship last July with a wedding fiasco. And now, he has slaughtered two of my favorite titans. Redhead Wally West, better known as The Flash for the late 80s and most in the entire 90s and part of the 2000s, and Arsenal, formerly known as Speedy, and Roy Harper. Ah, slime you, monster. Heroes in Crisis is awful. I don't understand how people can celebrate that bloody ugly filth. Lucy Rebirth is officially dead, I guess. It's heart and soul, Wally West is gone. Oh. Fortunately, there is one book this week that helped me endure this loss. I'm talking about Doomsday Clock, of course. This book has consistently been my top pick for DC Comics. I want to read more. This is a worthy sequel to the original Watchmen. As for the story, Dr. Manhattan finally shows up, blue penis and all, to show us his endgame. Ozymandias, of course, is the primary antagonist. We also finally get some answers to what happened to the JSA during the New 52. We also learn a shocking secret about Marionette. How I love Mime and Marionette. And let's not forget about the adorable red kitten, Bubastis II, or Bubastis II, who is the main focus of this chapter. The back matter of the book explains in detail Bubastis II's backstory, and why she is so important to Ozymandias' new plan to save not just one universe, but two. Gary Frank and Brad Anderson are a winning combination. Their art shines strong, with beautiful colors and detailed realistic pencils. I love it. I'm so eager for November to bring the next issue. This book is my last shred of hope left for the DC Universe, and it's also literally the last book left in my pull list from DC, at least until November, when Shazam number 1 and Batman 3 Jokers comes out. So, final verdict? Pull it! So, Amazing Spider-Man, Renew Your Vows, Volume 2, Issue 23, from Marvel Comics. Why is it that just when a book finally gets good, it gets canceled? Why? Why couldn't they bring their A game and find their boys from the start? That was my main problem with this book. The final issue before Spider-Geddon. It was fun and exciting. It was quite a page-turner, as comic books should be. Sure, the story of Annie Parker will continue in the Spider-Girls miniseries, but officially, this book is dead. A real shame, this comic is far more interesting and entertaining than Nick Spencer's Boar Fest. I would pick this book, Rainier Bowes, over Amazing and Peter Parker's Spectacular Spider-Man any day. The Spider family has a fantastic dynamic, and you can tell they love each other like a real-life family that understands and works with each other to overcome any obstacle. Normie Osborn's relationship with Annie is as endearing as it was a year ago, when the two were small children. Peter Parker is funny. He's actually funny again. It's been ages since I have laughed at any of Spidey's quips during battle. The running gag of Spider-Man hating the family car and wanting to see it destroyed was hilarious. This book also featured my favorite version of the X-Men. They were so cool. Way better than the mainstream X-Men. And I will miss this book. Final verdict? Pull it! And also, please consider giving us a spin-off featuring these X-Men. Please! Thank you. Vampironica, Issue 3, from Archie Comics. What can I say? Great pacing, exciting action, and beautiful art by Greg and Meg Smallwood. This issue was a blast to read. In the main Archie books, Dilton is often overlooked as the nerd and, you know, he's kind of lame and boring, but in this story, he was the hero and he was awesome. Unlike the Riverdale incarnation, these characters remain true to their classic characterization and narrative voice, albeit with a twist that builds upon said established characterization. It was so much fun with the pacing of this book. It took us to different settings and we confronted different adversaries. Almost felt like a 1980s adventure film. Archie, Veronica, and Dilton had excellent team dynamic and made this narrative and gorgeous art well worth my time. Final verdict? Pull it! Overall, this month we had a good score of all pools. Yay! Tune in next time. Au revoir. The running gag of Spider-Man hating the family